Good morning to everybody. I am Kevin Cianfaglione, and we will see the case study of Pinus alepensis in Abruzzo region, in coastal part of Abruzzo region, in central Adriatic Italy. Conifer species are often considered in the study area and in Italy also, as introduced as alien species that were introduced for historical reforestation purposes. Even if they could be considered as a native species or just as species reintroduced for hydrogeological stability of slopes. For that reason, we try, as possible, to clarify the status of these conifer species, so if they could be considered more as alien or are native species, using historical vegetation survey study. We provided an archival data study with a literature, available literature and toponymy analysis, including ancient maps. We selected the coastal sector of Pescara because of the largest amount of data and documents we found, both in a space and time scale. We also crossed the vegetation data we found with the actual, real, and potential vegetation. And we compared also the historical data with the vegetation that actually is still present in some similar part of the Italian peninsula and the Balkanic peninsula. We can start to say that the name Pescara, that is actually the name of the city of Pescara, the river of Pescara, and the valley of this river and the province of Pescara, belongs from the old ancient Greek time, and it means sea pine, coastal pine, maritime pine. And this was treated by several authors, this thematic, this linguistic thematic, as we can see in this list. The first and the most ancient, important ancient document we found is the Chronium Casauriense from the upper mid-age time. And here we can find this Flumen Pescarie, the river Pescara, with its valley rich on forests and on pine trees. Then, at the end of 14th century, we can find a nice map showing this ancient forest, ancient coastal forest of the study area. And we can see its limits. From the south, we have the river mouth of the Pescara River, and at the north, we have the river mouth of Saline River. Then we found a map of the 15th century showing the same forest with the same proportion and the same limits, always underlined in this red ring. And we can see also the name of this forest, Selva di Lentischi, meaning forest rich in Pistacia lentiscus. What is interesting is also the fact that we know that in the surroundings area, at that time, we had other forest portions, but they are not shown in maps. And this Selva di Lentischi is always represented and detailed. This led us to think that this forest was emblematic, was symbolic, we can see the representation of the forest also in a map from Cartarius, from the year 1579. And we can see also a representation from 1587 in a map from Natale Bonifacio. We can see also this forest in this map from 1590. And we can see also that the Pescara fortress at the south is very evident. This is important because this forest was harvested and some portion were deforested to harvest lumber to restore this, this fortress. In some pictures of the last century, we can see some fragments, remains of this ancient forest to the right and to the left side of the Pescara River mouth. We can see here another vision of these fragments. In 1943, we can see really, really few fragments in the city. Now we have almost the surface transformed in city, and to the right we have some agricultural landscape, and to the extreme right we can find this more black color corresponding to the last important fragment of this forest, actually known as Pineta d'Annunziana. To the left, we have another small fragment still existing, actually known as Pineta di Santa Filomena, but actually is more like a urban green area than a wild forest. Even both Pineta d'Annunziana and Pineta di Santa Filomena are actually protected areas. But Pineta di Santa Filomena is managed as a urban green area, more than a wild area. In a more recent aerial picture, we can see that all the other small fragments are disappeared, and the Pineta d'Annunziana still exists to the right, even if some portion were urbanized. We have no more agricultural fields, and even the stadium was built inside this pine forest. More in detail, we have found the description of this pine forest, this ancient pine forest, from Bernardino Razzi in 1576. He described this forest as so beautiful that it was a garnish for the sea. And he described also its morphological characteristics. And he said that it was full of dry wood, necromass. So it was really, really wild and full of understory. The forest was so thick and so wild that people not used to move through this forest, but they moved in the sea using small boats. In 1653, huge cuts of the forest were documented to the reinforcement of the Pescara fortress, and they resulted in hard protest by local population who depend to the forest province, because this forest was not mainly used for wood, for lumber, but for the secondary woody products. Palma in 1837 noted that on the sea level grows naturally the Vitex aniogastus, the Pistacia lentiscus, Rosmarinum officinale, Myrtus communis, Juniperus deltoides, and Pinus alepensis. He stated that before the deforestation, that forest served as shield against invasion coming from the sea. Comparing all the data about vegetation and plant species presence in the past time with the actual vegetation, so real and potential vegetation, using so vegetation databases in the literature, we can frame this forest, this ancient forest, as follows. We had on the dune, on the driest and hotter portion, the Coronillo emeroides, Pinetum alepensis, and the portion of Pistacio, Pinetum alepensis, with shrubland belonging from the Myrto communis, Pistacetum lentisci, and the Pistacio lentisci, Juniperetum oxycede. In more moist portion, we could have the typical vegetation of dune slacks, and also forest of Salix alba, Annus glutinosa, Populus nigra, Ulmus campestris, and even forest of patches of Quercus robur and Fraxinus excelsior and Oxyphilus. This type of vegetation, it was a common planisial vegetation, so from the Italian coast and the bottom valleys. This vegetation was was completely destroyed to make place for settlements and for agriculture. We carried out also a fossil pollen analysis using literature, and we found that pine species were really, really common until the mid-age. Then they were slowly disappearing, and the authors normally make the hypothesis that it was the anthropization, the main factor of this conifer disparition. We make also an DNA analysis of the veteran trees, looking for the possibility that the trees could correspond to this ancient forest presence. And this DNA analysis was really interesting for this, because showed a special character, a special differentiation, could differentiate these veteran trees by other trees from other Italian localities and from Balkanic peninsula localities. And this led us to think that they should really be the last fragments of this ancient forest. The main uses of this old forest, so the main old traditional uses of this forest, were partially lumber and timber. Also, dead wood generally was used at full purpose, and only this was used at full purpose, and mainly was the myrtle thicket harvested for tanning and resin harvesting. So these last were the most important uses of the forest. And the largest surface of this forest was not used and untouched. The harvesting of other and the uses of other pine species could be not excluded a priori. For that reason, they conclude that Pinus halepensis was the most widespread species between conifers in that forest, and that conifers, and especially Pinus halepensis in this case study, are to be considered as a flag species and not as alien species. And this method could be used also to clarify this native or non-native status for species, even in other parts of the world. Thank you for your attention.